promotional consideration paid for by the following.
I always like to keep my favorite snack handy. Need a little excitement? Step into a Slim Jim. Oh, yeah.
Can you feel your heart beating faster? That's because the WWF Heart Attack World Tour is getting closer. The Heart Attack World Tour is taking the tri-state area by storm. Be at the Meadowlands Arena Thursday, October 27th, Nassau Coliseum Friday night, October 28th, and Madison Square Garden Saturday night, October 29th, just 3 weeks away. Get into the spirit and look your spookiest. The best pallbearer look-alike will win a fabulous prize. Watch out for special seating in the Dead Zone and Tombstone Row. Just look at who's gonna be there. Special appearance by Bob Backlund, in which he issues the Bob Backlund Challenge. The 1-2-3 Kid squares off against Abe Knuckleball Schwartz. Duke the Dumpster Drossy takes on the Taxman IRS. In tag action, the Smoking Guns square off against the Heavenly Bodies. Plus, Doink with Dink taking on Jerry Lawler with the Prince. Made in the USA, Lex Luger squares off against one-time friend Tatanka. The WWF title on the line as the Hitman Bret Hart dangles the gold in front of the evil anvil Jim Neidhart. And this time, it's personal. Paul Bearer's Undertaker squares off against Yokozuna. You can get your tickets to these amazing events at all arena box offices and all Ticketmaster outlets. In Jersey, 201-507-8900 or 609-520-8383. On Long Island, 516-888-9000. And in New York, 212-307-7171. And fans, be on the lookout for the man from the dark side and his funeral coach. Standing nearly 40 feet tall, The Undertaker hasn't gotten out in a while, and he might be taking in the sights around New York October 26th, 27th, 28th, and 29th. Be at the Meadowlands Arena Thursday night, October 27th, Nassau Coliseum Friday night, October 28th, and Madison Square Garden Saturday night, October 29th, only 3 weeks away.
Let's take you back down, ladies and gentlemen, and chronicle the career of the former World Wrestling Federation champion, a very bitter Bob Backlund.
Bob Backlund has always been a competitor and an athlete. In his younger school days, he continually defeated his competition both on the football field and especially the wrestling mat. While attending North Dakota State University, Bob Backlund won the NCAA tournament and was crowned the amateur national wrestling champion. In 1976, he entered the World Wrestling Federation. Then, on February 20th, 1978, Bob Backlund became the WWF champion. During his tenure as champion, Bob Backlund was revered as the All-American Boy. Backlund used his strength, ring savvy, and inherent technical skills to hold on to the WWF title for nearly 6 years. Then, on December 26, 1983, his reign as champion ended as Arnold Skolin, Backlund's longtime manager, threw in the towel to end the match. And still, to this day, Backlund denies ever giving up. After nearly a 10-year hiatus, Bob Backlund began his preparation to return to the WWF for one reason only, and that was to once again fulfill his dream and become the WWF champion. Then, finally, on July 30th of this year, Bob Backlund got that chance when he faced the current WWF champion, Bret the Hitman Hart. It was a seesaw battle from the get-go, matching hold for hold and counter for counter as both combatants pulled out all the stops. And then it happened. Backlund rolled up Bret Hart and thought he had won the match, won the title once again. However, Backlund's dream was shattered in a fraction of a second with a small package by the Hitman. At that moment, Bob Backlund realized that his goal of once again becoming champion was destroyed. As the realization of the loss set in, the once admired and respected Backlund lost all self-control and cinched in the dreaded chicken wing crossface on the champion. His lack of self-control again became evident when 2 weeks ago, during a very accusatory interview on Raw, Bob Backlund challenged anyone in the world that if they could escape the chicken wing crossface, he would retire for good.
I said, if anybody gets away from it, I'll retire for good.
then, what was to only be a demonstration of the excruciating hold turned into a nightmare for his volunteers. Backlund had snapped once again. Our cameras caught up with Bob Backlund while on a recent wrestling tour of Japan, and here's what he had to say.
You people have had a deleterious effect on the Japanese people. There's a vexatious balkanization going on here, and it's because of you. You forget that there's other people and other nations that are following in your footsteps. And I'm here to warn these people to stay strong and don't crumble to the ways of the United States.
The world over, ladies and gentlemen, extremely disappointed in Bob Backlund, but here comes somebody we can be proud of. I saw Oscar earlier.
Well, I don't know where Oscar is.
Hey, you think maybe Mabel got a little hungry and thought maybe his last name was Meyer? Hey, look, there's no Mo either.
Oh, my goodness. There he comes, ladies and gentlemen, the rap master himself. He's huge.
Give a dog a bone. No, don't give him nothing for the microphone. Don't stop.
I bet Knuckleball knows what his favorite kind of ball is.
You want to make a bet? Throw your hands in the air.
Tell him.
You know who it is. If you're ready to get it, get it with me, man.
You call that talent?
There it is. Come on, move.
I'll tell you one thing. Double J can't get him up like this. Look at that rhythm. Listen to the rhyme.
Look at those idiots.
And Mabel's having a good old time in there, having a big time.
Everything about him's big. I was going to say, Knuckleball knows what Mabel's favorite kind of ball is, a meatball.
You know, you haven't been nice at all this week. Why don't you, like, turn over a new leaf, okay?
For what?
Well, I mean, it's autumn, you know, I mean, make like a tree, a leaf, you know.
Oh, that's real funny.
Sorry, apologize. By the way, the weekend of the WWF Heart Attack Tour in the greater New York City metropolitan area, a busy one, where our WWF superstars on Friday, October 28th, Dink, Doink, Adam Bomb will be at Sports World in Paramus to help WPOJ raise money for the Mended Heart Children's Charity. Then on Saturday, October 29th, from 1 to 3 o'clock in the afternoon, many of the top superstars will be in Union, New Jersey, take on the Union All-Stars in a softball game. Matter of fact, you're going to be there.
Oh, yeah, I'm going to be there. But it's not going to be any charity where I'm involved. I have no mercy on you.
Yeah, right. Tickets for the game, by the way, on sale now at the Boys and Girls Club in Union. Proceeds for the game go towards the Joey Morella Memorial Athletic Scholarship Fund and the Cure Kid campaign. So please join us either Friday at Sports World in Paramus or Saturday afternoon in Union and help us raise funds for these worthy charities.
I want to ask you a question. You think Mabel could play any ball? This guy sits around all day watching his favorite soap opera, One Life to Eat. Look at him.
One Life to Eat?
Yeah. I'll tell you what I would do. Probably the same thing Mr. Backlund would do. Slap that chicken wing crossface on him.
Uh-huh. Sure you would.
I think that's what happened to Oscar, as a matter of fact.
Close line there by Anderson. Anderson trying to get the big man down. Trying to kick in. No, Mabel regains his balance. Anderson going to the well too often. Mabel, look out! Oh, wow! Unbelievable! And I think Anderson has had it after that.
That might be how I'd get him down.
How's that?
I'd lie down on the mat. He'd go to give me that big, gigantic elbow. I'd just move out of the way.
Yeah, sure you would. Oh, my goodness! And then that might happen to you. And then Mabel would take a nap and wake up whenever he would want to.
Hey, hand me my royal magistrator. I'm going to show you what I really think of Mabel. I'm going to draw you a little picture here.
Don't be picking on Mabel.
Go ahead and talk while I get this ready.
I want to hear Mabel rap again.
Oh, please.
He is the supreme rap master. He's got to be the biggest man in rap today, that's for sure.
He reminds me of, not Snoop Doggy Dog, but Puke Doggy Dog.
Puke Doggy Dog.
That's right.
I don't believe I've heard of that. Puke Doggy.
You're hearing him right now. Listen to this.
All right, Mabel, show me how it's done. Oh, boy.
They are behind this WWF superstar all the way, I can tell you that.
Yeah, speaking of behinds, let me show you what I think of him here. See that big white streak down the middle of his head? What does that remind you of? Anything special? Huh?
Well, special, yet.
Well, just
Mabel.
Let me show you what I think of Mabel. This is what he reminds me of. And for more than one reason. Not just his hygienic habits, but his wrestling skills and abilities.
Hygienic habits?
Do you see what I'm drawing here?
I haven't the vaguest idea what that is.
It's a skunk! And look, his breath smells like one too!
Oh my goodness. Oh my. Well, speaking of big men, ladies and gentlemen, there's a monster on the loose, and he's headed to the WWF. He was last seen trampling through downtown Manhattan, New York City.
Of Jim the Anvil Neidhart attacking his opponent here, Ike Andrews. And Andrews is having problems, as perhaps the British Bulldog will have this Monday night. What a matchup that's going to be. Jim the Anvil Neidhart against the British Bulldog.
Well, I was glad to see the Anvil come down there because I was having my problems interviewing the British Bulldog.
You were having problems?
Oh, yeah. I found out that's one dog whose breath is worse than his bark. Come to think of it, it's worse than his bite, too.
And wherever you see the Anvil, you will see as well the King of Hearts, Owen. And no doubt we will see Owen at ringside this Monday when the Anvil squares off against British Bulldog.
He's talking to you.
No, I don't believe so.
These guys are inseparable. They're like real brothers.
The Anvil, Jim Neidhart, former tag team partner of the WWF champion Bret Hart. They were the Hart Foundation, and on two occasions, they were tag team champions. And if anyone knows the skills of Bret Hart and knows what makes Bret Hart tick, that's Jim the Anvil Neidhart.
That's right. But you made one wrong statement. You said they were the Hart Foundation. The truth of the matter is, he was the Hart Foundation. Jim the Anvil Neidhart.
Please.
I started to say he carried, but he actually drug the hitman along.
I don't believe that was the case at all.
You'll see when they face each other.
Yes, indeed, we shall. Jim the Anvil Neidhart, big, powerful. A few screws loose, I would suggest. Really taking it to Ike Andrews, much like he would like to do. Against, you hear this crowd about We Want Bret.
Come on, right down all these comments you make.
You know?
Yeah, about the screws being loose. I'm going to give it to the Anvil.
I really don't know that he would disagree with that. The Anvil in complete control against Ike Andrews. Wait a minute.
Oh, yeah, look at this.
And